Good morning, students. Welcome to this video session. I remain Samuel Chukwu Emeka, aka Sam Dumb for Peace. In this video session, we shall discuss absolute value equations. What is an absolute value of a term or a number? Let us look at the number line for a moment. The number line, the real number line. So you see that zero is in the center of the number line. To the right of zeros, you have the positive real numbers. To the left of zero, you have the negative real numbers. If we are looking at the distance, let's look at the distance from negative 3 to 0 and also the distance from 3, from 0 to 3. And if we are only interested in the magnitude, what we call magnitude or modulus, magnitude or the modulus, if we are actually interested in the what is the exact distance from negative 3 to 0, we really are not interested in the direction, okay? Because the negatives, you can look at, if you look at this real number line, you can look at the negative numbers as, okay, they are negatives because they are to the left of 0. And for the positive numbers, they are positive numbers because they are to the right of zero. So if we are not looking at it with direction, okay, we are not interested in direction. We are just interested in the magnitude or the modulus, okay? Then you can see that the distance from this is still 3. You can call it feet, assuming it's in feet, and the distance of this is still 3 feet. Let's say the unit is in feet. Okay? So this is known as the absolute value. So you see that absolute value of that negative 3 is still 3, and the absolute value of 3 is still 3. So when we talk of absolute value, we are really interested in only the magnitude or the modulus. We are not concerned about the direction. Okay, we are not concerned about the signs. So the actual magnitude of that. Okay, and if you look at the relationship to physics, you talk about vector quantities and scalar quantities, right? So vector quantities are quantities that have both magnitude and direction. Scalar quantities are physical quantities that have only magnitude. Okay, so the thing that what you should know is that the absolute value of a term, the absolute value, okay, of a number is the magnitude. We call it the magnitude or modulus. Magnitude or modulus of the number. And let's say term. Let's just say term also. Term. Because we could have variables. We could have the constants and variables. Okay. Is the magnitude or modulus of the number or term without regard to signs, So, and you know, some graphing calculators or some computer programs, they say ABS, you know, absolute value of something, absolute value of negative 5, some have it that way. Okay, Now, some you will just see it as the absolute value sign. Absolute value sign. So, it just depends on how you see it. No. ABS or the magnitude or modulus. Modulus. Okay, so, now, there is something to note here. The thing to note here is that, okay, there are two things to note. Two things to note, and you can write it down. Two things to note. Number one, the absolute value of the term will never be negative. Never. Okay? It will never be negative. Remember, we could care less about the signs. Okay? So it will never be negative. That's number one. So, number two, but the terms inside, the terms inside that absolute value. So, number one, the result of the absolute value, number one, write it down, the result of the absolute value of a number or a term will never be negative. Okay? Number two, that number or term could still be negative though. Okay? That number or term could still be negative. So, in that case, whenever we are solving absolute value equations or inequality, we shall look at the absolute value inequality in another video. So, we are going to consider those two possibilities, that the term or the number inside that absolute value sign could be positive or negative. We shall consider both. But the result of it is always going to be positive. Let's get started. Okay. Let's get started solving problems. Question one, because this is an equation, is solve and check. Remember, with Mr. C, anything called equations or inequalities will be solve and check. Okay. Before, the prerequisite to this video is that you should know linear equations. The prerequisite to this video is that you should know linear equations. So when you get on my website, under algebra, in the videos tab, check for linear equations and go over it. Okay. Number one, let's start this one. Absolute value of 8p, 8 minus 4p, 8 minus 4p, minus 1 equal to 9. Okay? Now, the first thing you want to do whenever you solve absolute values, just like we did for radical equations, if you are solving for absolute value equations, you want the absolute value term to be left alone. Okay, you want to isolate the absolute value term. So first, that's the first thing you want to do. If somebody is with it, kick the person out. Okay, so negative one should be kicked out to the other side. We now have absolute value of 8 minus 4p equal to 9 plus 1. So absolute value of 8 minus 4p equal to 10. Okay? Now you get this absolute value term is isolated. Then you have to consider, remember the second thing to note. The thing inside the absolute value. Now, the result of that absolute value is 10, so we are good, okay? If the result is 10, that's the first thing, we are good. Now, but the thing inside that absolute value could be positive or it could be negative. So this is that 8 minus 4p is equal to 10, or negative 8 minus 4p equal to 10. So you look at this. Look at both cases. If you put this negative, please don't just write minus 8 minus 4p. No. Okay, this is an entity. It is an entity. So you have to put the negative sign. You have to put the negative. You have to put negative sign before the parenthesis. You have to put this in parenthesis. So in this case, 8 minus 10 is equal to 40. So the way I solve my equations, I don't like negative signs. So I move this over here, brought this over here. Negative 2 is 4p. 4p is negative 2. So p is negative 2 over 4, which is negative 1 over 2. Okay? Negative 1 over 2. This is the first one. Then here, you can distribute if you want to. If you want to, you can distribute, or you can divide both sides by negative 1. For me, I prefer to divide both sides by negative 1. But I will show you also that you can distribute. So this is divided by negative 1 over negative 1. Negative divide negative is positive. So 8 minus 4p is equal to negative 10. Okay, 8 minus 4p is equal to negative 10. So from here, we have that 8 plus 10 is equal to 4p. 18 is equal to 4p. 4p is equal to 18. So p is 18 over 4. P is 9 over 2. If you want to distribute, that's also fine. If you want to distribute. If you distribute, you have it like this. Negative 8 minus 4p equal to 10. In that case, you will have to, view the video, I did on the distributive property. Okay. So if you distribute, this is like saying negative 1. So this is negative 8 plus 4p equal to 10. And you can do 4p equal to 10 plus 8. 4p equal to 18. If you want to do that. I prefer to do my divide both sides by negative. That's what I prefer. Okay, do you stop here? No. You've got to do what? Check your work. So we check, and like we have been doing, you check with the main equation. You do not check with the modified equation. You check with the main equation. Why do you do that? Because the modified equation might be wrong. So our left hand side and our right hand side. So left hand side, we have 8 minus 4p, absolute value of 8 minus 4p minus 1. Right hand side is 9. We check, we start with p equal to negative 1 half. So this means 8 minus 4 times negative 1 half minus 1. And that is 8 minus 2 into 2 is 1. 2 into 4 is 2. 8 minus 2 times negative 1 is negative 2. Minus 1. Okay? So this is absolute value of 8 plus 2. Minus 1. Absolute value of 10. Minus 1. Which is 10 minus 1. Which is 9. So this works. Okay? That works. We now check for the other one, p equal to 9 over 2. This will be absolute value of 8 minus 4 times 9 over 2 minus 1. And that will be absolute value of 8 minus 2 into 2 is 1, 2 into 4 is 2. 2 times 9 is 18. Okay? 8 minus 18. This will be absolute value of negative 10 minus 1. Absolute value of negative 10 is still 10. So 10 minus 1 is equal to 9. Okay? So this also works. And it is very, very important to check your absolute value equations because of the possibility of extraneous roots. Very important. just like we did in radicals, okay, radical equations. Okay, let's do question two. Anyone we do, we just check it out. We knock it off. Next one we have here, number two, absolute value of 3g plus 18 equal to 3g equal to 6g. 3g plus 18 equal to 6g. Solve and check. Okay? So, the term inside the absolute value could be positive or it could be negative. So this means that 3g plus 18 is equal to 6g, or negative, you put the, this is an entity. Negative 3g plus 18 is equal to 6g. So here, this will be 18 equal to 6g minus 3g. 18 is equal to 3g. So 3g is equal to 18, and g will be 18 divided by 3, g will be 6. Here, or you divide both sides by negative 1. So when you do that, this will be 3g plus 18 equal to negative 6g. Bring this guy over here. Take this guy over there. 3g plus 6g equal to negative 18. 9g equal to negative 18. G will be negative 18 over 9. G will be negative 2. Okay? Do we stop here? No. We have to do what? Check our work. So we write here our left hand side and our right hand side. We check with the main equation. Left hand side we have absolute value of 3g plus 18. Right hand side we have 6g. So let us check with g equal to 6. G equal to 6. This means that this is 3 times 6 plus 18. This will be absolute value of 3 times 6 is 18 plus 18. And that will be absolute value of 36, which is what? 36. Yes, this will be 6 times 6, and that is 36. So this works. G equal to 6. It works. Okay? The second one, let's check for g equal to negative 2. This will be 3 times negative 2 plus 18. Absolute value of 3 times negative 2 plus 18. And that would be negative 6 plus 18. That is 12. Absolute value of 12, which is what? 12. Okay? The right hand side will be 6 times negative 2, right? 6 times negative 2, which is negative 12. So, you see what I'm talking about with this. 12 is not equal to negative 12. And because of that, g equal to negative 2 is an extraneous root. Is an extraneous root. Okay? It's not a solution. Okay? Comprende? Do you understand? Okay, the next one, question 3. I think we have about We have probably less than 10 questions in this video. Probably about less than 10 or about 10. I just want to touch on every variety, okay? Every variety. So you will understand it. So you will understand it. Question 3. Here we have absolute value of x plus 10 equal to absolute value of x. Okay. X plus 10 equal to 10. So now, look at this, folks. When you have double absolute value, right? When you have two absolute values. So in this case, you know, you also consider both ways, that this could be positive equal to positive, or this could be negative equal to negative. And that boils down to just one aspect. Okay, I'll show you. So here, this is that x plus 10 is equal to x, or negative x plus 10 is equal to negative x. So you see that you are pretty much saying the same thing here, okay? Because if you divide both sides by negative 1, it gives you this. So you're pretty much saying the same thing, okay? You're pretty much saying the same thing here. So you can also consider it here that x plus 10 is equal to negative x, or negative x plus 10 is equal to x. Okay? You can also consider both ways. Now you see that this is the same thing as this. Okay? You can also consider the fact that this positive could be this negative, or that this negative could be this positive. Okay? Alright, so this is the same thing as this, so we are good with this. Okay, we are good with this. Now if you try to solve this here, x plus 10 equal to x, because this and this are the same. So now this will be x minus x equal to negative 10, and this will be 0 equal to negative 10. This is a contradiction. Okay? It's a contradiction. No solution. No solution. Okay? Right? Now, you can also take it from here, and you see that here, this and this is the same thing too. This and this is the same thing. Same old, right? You say same old, same old. Same old, same old. Yeah, because guess what? If you divide this by negative one, you will get this. If you divide both sides here by negative one, you get this. So let's just pick one of them. If we have x plus 10 to be negative x, this will be that x plus x is negative 10. So 2x is negative 10, and then x will be negative 5. Okay, you divide both sides by 2. X is negative 5. Because this and this, they are the same. If you divide this both sides by negative 1, you get this. Okay, so this has no solution. Now this has a solution. Now let's check. So when you have these two absolute values, do it positive equal to positive, negative equal to negative. Negative of this equal to positive of this is still possible, or positive of this equal to negative of this. You consider it all four ways. Okay? Typically you have the same either way, you know. Alright, so let's now check our work. So if we check this, we have the left hand side and the right hand side. Left hand side is absolute value of x plus 10. Right hand side is absolute value of x. And our x is equal to negative 5. Right? So this will be absolute value of negative 5 plus 10, which is absolute value of 5, which is 5. Okay? And this will be absolute value of negative 5, which is still 5. So this works. Okay?
Do you understand? Do you understand it? Do you understand it?
Question 4. Knock this off. We have this, okay? Absolute value of 8k plus 7 plus 9 equal to 2. So with this, we want the absolute value to be by itself, okay? We want the absolute value to be isolated by itself. So we move this 9 over here. This is absolute value of 8x plus 7 equal to 2 minus 9. So absolute value of 8x plus 7 equal to negative 7. Okay, remember the first thing we said that you should note? The first thing, that the result of the absolute value will never be negative. It will never be negative, okay? So this is no solution. It will never be negative because this is negative. So no, it's no solution. Anytime you find absolute value of something and the result gives you negative, then no. Now the inside could be positive or negative, okay? But whatever it gives you, the result must be positive, must. Because it's the magnitude or the modulus without signs. Okay? All right, question 5. Question 5. I have a decimal this time. 3.5 minus absolute value. And I just want to do several varieties, you know. Absolute value of 3 plus d equal to negative 2.4. Okay, the same method we've been using, okay? Let's pull this guy out. Let's put this guy over here. We want the absolute value to be by itself. So we now have, the first thing we do, negative absolute value of 3 plus d equal to negative 2.4 minus 3.5. Negative absolute value of 3 plus d equal to, you owe $2.40. And you owe $3.50. You owe somebody. So this is negative 5.9, right? 5.9. Now, we still want absolute value to be by itself. So we divide both sides by negative 1. We divide both sides by negative 1. So negative divided by negative is positive. So absolute value of 3 plus d is equal to 5.9. Now we can do it the way we've been doing it. So we see that 3 plus d is equal to 5.9 or negative 3 plus d is equal to 5.9. Okay? So, this will give that d is equal to 5.9 minus 3, so d will be 2.9. Or, if we divide both sides by negative 1, so this is that 3 plus d is negative 5.9, so d will be negative 5.9 minus 3, d will be negative 8.9. Okay? Do we stop here? No way. We have to do what?
Check our work. Check our work.
Check our work. So, check. We check with the main equation 3.5 minus absolute value of 3 plus d equal to 2.4. Negative 2.4. Please do not check with the modified equation, no. You check with the main equation. Left hand side, right hand side. Right hand side is negative 2.4. Left hand side is 3.5 minus absolute value of 3 plus d. So we start with d equal to 2.9. So this will be 3.5 minus absolute value of 3 plus 2.9, right? And this will be 3.5 minus absolute value of 5.9, right? So this will be 3.5 minus 5.9. And that will give us what? Negative 2.4. So this works. It works, 2.9 works. The next one is d equal to negative 8.9. Negative 8.9. This will be 3.5 minus absolute value of 3 plus negative 8.9. Are you with me? So this will be 3.5 minus absolute value plus minus is minus 3 minus 8.9. And this will be 3.5 minus absolute value of negative 5.9. Okay? And this will be 3.5 minus absolute value of negative 5.9 is 5.9. And this gives us negative 2.4. The same thing. The same thing. And this means that this works too. Okay? Alright, question 6. Question 6. We are getting there.
Getting there.
Getting there.
We are getting there.
Getting there. This is done. Question 6. Let's solve another one that has two absolute values. How about that? Okay, varieties. Absolute value of 5f plus 6 equal to absolute value of 2f minus 3. Okay, so here we consider, let's consider the four ways. Typically, we have two ways to be the same anyway. So, eventually, it's like two ways. But let's look at it. So, we could say that either 5f plus 6 is equal to 2f minus 3, or Negative 5x plus 6 is equal to negative 2x minus 3. This is the same. You're just saying the same thing. Okay? Then we can also say negative 5x plus 6 is equal to 2x minus 3. Okay? Or we could say 5x plus 6 is negative 2x minus 3. These two are the same. Okay? We're going to do both and then we find out what works. Okay? Alright, let's start with this one. So, we'll try to use the simplest ones. 5x plus 6 equal to 2f minus 3. This is that 5f minus 2f is minus 3 minus 6. So, this is 3f is minus 9. So, f is minus 3. Okay? F is negative 3. Now, with this one here, let's use this one. Yeah, because if you divide both sides by negative 1, you get this two. So here, we have 5f plus 6 equal to negative 2f minus 3. We distribute here. We have to distribute the right-hand side. So this is 5f plus 6 equal to negative 2f plus 3. Okay? Negative 2f plus 3. And this will be 5f plus 2f equal to 3 minus 6. So this is 7f equal to minus 3. So f will be negative 3 over 7. Okay. We have to do what next?
Check our work.
Okay. 7f. 3 minus 6, okay. So now let's go ahead and check our work, folks. Let's check our work. 5f plus 6 is equal to 2f minus 3. Left hand side, right hand side. The left hand side is 5f plus 6. Right-hand side is absolute value 2f minus 3. Both are absolute values. Now, let's start with f equal to negative 3. Okay, so this is 5 times negative 3 plus 6. Absolute value. Absolute value of negative 15 plus 6. So, absolute value of negative 9, which will give us 9. Okay? Here would be absolute value of 2 times negative 3 minus 3. Absolute value of negative 6 minus 3. Absolute value of negative 9, which will give us 9. So this works. That one works. It's a solution. Now let's do the, let's check for this other root. Let us check for this other root. So, the left-hand side and the right-hand side. Here you have absolute value. Here, f is negative 3 over 7. Okay? So, absolute value of 5 times negative 3 over 7 plus 6. And here will be absolute value of 2 times negative 3 over 7 plus minus 3. Okay, so this will be absolute value of negative 15 over 7 plus 6 over 1, which is absolute value of negative 15 over 7 plus 42 over 7. Okay, please add fractions. Look up videos on adding and subtracting fractions. Okay, the videos I did on add and subtract fractions. So you should understand what I did now. I have to make them to have a common denominator. Okay? So this is absolute value of negative 15 plus 42 over 7, which is absolute value of 12 minus 5 is 7. 3 minus 1 is 2, 27 over 7. And that will give us 27 over 7. Right? Now the next one will be absolute value of negative 6 over 7 minus 3. And this is absolute value of negative 6 over 7. This is multiplying fractions. Because this is 2 over 1. Okay, multiplying. Minus 6 over 7 minus 21 over 7. Okay, this is minus 27 because this is minus 6 minus 21 all over 7. And that would be absolute value of negative 27 over 7, which is still 27 over 7. So this works. Both of them work. Okay. All right. We knocked that one off. I think we have one more. This is 6. One more. Last but not the least. Last but not the least. Question 7. And then you can watch out for. This is part 1, which I will have. Most likely we might, you know, when I have time, we'll do part 2. Part 2 will probably do word problems. And then we solve those two. So, last but not the least here. I think I've touched the varieties that are here. If you have any variety and you cannot solve it, feel free to ask me. There was something I saw here we can do. Negative 2, absolute value of, and it's still the same principle. Still the same principle. 3 minus x over 3 plus absolute value plus 1 equal to negative 5. Okay. All right. So we want the app. It is the same principle we have been solving. It's just linear equations. Okay. It's just linear equations. So we want absolute value to be by itself. We want to isolate it. So push this over here first. You have that negative 2 absolute value of 3 minus x over 3 equal to minus 5 minus 1. Okay? So this is negative 2 absolute value of 3 minus x over 3 equal to minus 6. Then you divide both sides by minus 2. Okay? You want the absolute value to be by itself. Divide both sides by minus 2. So this is minus 2 absolute value 3 minus x over 3 equal to minus 6. This is over minus 2. This is over minus 2. Bam, bam. That's gone. Okay. Bam, bam. Some students say they like that. Bam, bam. Okay, this is absolute value of 3 minus x over 3 equal to 3. Right? Okay, so this could be positive or it could be negative. This one is already positive, so we're good. Okay, so this will be 3 minus x over 3 is equal to 3 or negative 3 minus x over 3 is equal to 3. Okay, are you with me? So here, just take this over here. Minus, well, I wanna, this is minus, so I'm moving here, bring this guy here. 3 minus 3 is equal to x over 3. Linear equations. View the videos I did on linear equations. So 0 is equal to x over 3. X over 3 is equal to 0. Multiply both sides by the LCD, by 3. Fractional equations. X is equal to 3 times 0, and x is equal to 0. Okay? Excuse me. Here, divide both sides by negative 1. So you have that 3 minus x over 3 is negative 3. Bring this over here. Take this over there. 3 plus 3 is x over 3. So 6 is x over 3. X over 3 is equal to 6. So this implies that x is equal to 3 times 6, x is equal to 18. Do we stop here?
No. No way. We have to check our work.
Okay, so this is the equation here. This is our left-hand side, and this is our right-hand side. Well, let me just write it here. Right-hand side is negative 5. Left-hand side, negative 2, absolute value 3 minus x over 3, then plus 1. Okay? So we start with x equal to 0. This is negative 2, absolute value of 3 minus 0 over 3, close the absolute value, plus 1. So this is negative 2, absolute value of 3 minus 0 divided by 3 will give us 0, then plus 1. Then negative 2, absolute value of 3 plus 1. Okay? Then negative 2 times 3 plus 1. And that is negative 6 plus 1, which is negative 5. Negative 5 on your left, negative 5 on your right. You do some exercise, you know. You do some modeling exercise. Because you got it right. Hey, but this is only 1. So you're still breathing in. Don't read that yet because you have not checked this second one. So when you check the second one, then you finish it. All right, so let's check the second one. The left-hand side is the one that is important. So here, x equal to 18. So this is negative 2, absolute value of 3 minus 18 over 3, then plus 1, which is negative 2, absolute value 3 minus 18 divided by 3 is 6, then plus 1, absolute value negative 2 times negative 3 plus 1, negative 2 times absolute value of negative 3 plus 1, then this is negative 2 times absolute value of negative 3 is 3 plus 1, which is negative 6 plus 1, which is negative 5. Negative 5 on your left, negative 5 on your right. You do more exercise. Then, then out. Okay? Alright, we're going to stop here for this morning. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. Watch out for other videos.
Are you having great?